We enjoyed our 11th straight day of blue skies today, and tonight it turned a beautiful shade of orange over southwest Sydney, a gorgeous sunset descending over the city and in Campbelltown. Nights once again much colder than average, but daytime temperatures 2 or 3 degrees warmer than usual for this time of year. We saw tops of around 21 to 23 degrees across most of the Sydney basin. It was mainly sunny across New South Wales, except in the southwest, which was cloudy with the odd shower. Tomorrow, a front will cross Tasmania and clip southern Victoria, and that will trigger some showers and gusty winds, but a high will keep most of New South Wales clear. Brisbane will be sunny tomorrow, 24 degrees, cloudy and 15 in Canberra, with a shower or two on the way for Melbourne, heading for a top of 19. Most of New South Wales will be dry tomorrow, just a few possible showers around Albury. It will be another cold morning, but not quite as cold as today, and then it will warm up to around 21 along the south coast, 20 in Griffith and Dubbo, Newcastle and Narrabri expecting a top of around 22 degrees. After possible fog in the west, Sydney will be partly cloudy tomorrow morning. There will be increasing cloud in the afternoon with light northwesterly winds. After lows of 5 to 9 degrees, we're looking at tops of around 21 right across our western suburbs, including Penrith and Liverpool, 20 on the way for Terrey Hills and Cronulla, 21 for Gosford and the city. Let's take a look ahead, and Thursday will be partly cloudy to kick off the first day of winter, and it will be quite mild, heading for 23 degrees, mostly sunny on Friday, 21, and the weekend will start off fine, heading for a top of 23 degrees before showers move in on Sunday and early next week. Those nights warming up a little after tonight, ranging from 9 to 14 degrees. In our west, partly cloudy and 24 on Thursday, mostly sunny and 22 on Friday. It should stay fine on Saturday before a cold front brings showers and cooler temperatures on Sunday. Those nights range from 7 to 12 degrees. Pete?
Amber, thank you.
Hello again. The city enjoyed both a minimum and maximum well above the May average. It dipped to 12.7 before reaching 18.7 this afternoon. The mild conditions extended right around the city, with most spots peaking at 17 or 18 degrees. Werribee and Moorabbin got to 19, 14 at Ferny Creek, and there's been a few light showers over the Dandenong Ranges, but it has stayed dry elsewhere. And there's been nothing more than a sprinkle anywhere around the state today. And while most areas were under cloud, there was more blue sky through the far east, so that was the warmest part of the state, with Orbost and Mallacoota reaching 21. But it was quite cool through the northeast again, 14 at Wodonga, just 13 for Rutherglen, mostly 15 to 17 elsewhere. Tomorrow, a cold front will approach from the south, but it's not expected to arrive until late in the day, and it looks like the associated showers will move across the state overnight into Thursday. So for the first day of winter, our daylight hours should be mostly dry, and while it'll be a little cooler, we're still expecting maximums slightly higher than average. Brisbane will finish autumn on a beautiful sunny note, warm too, with a top of 24, 21 in Sydney, cloudy skies for Canberra and 15, 17 in Hobart, but there'll be showers about. Adelaide is heading for a partly cloudy top of 20, 21 for Perth, with up to 15 millimetres of showers. Victoria can expect above average maximums to round out the season. The high teens for most of the state, 20 degrees through much of Gippsland, 21 in the Mallee and 20, and it'll stay dry for most of the day. Showers should arrive in the southwest in the early evening before extending across the rest of the state overnight, and the Bureau has warned that winds will become damaging across the Alps and through West Gippsland around Warragul late tomorrow night into Thursday morning, with gusts of more than 90 kilometres an hour. Now, tonight, it'll be mild across Melbourne, with minimums expected to stay in double figures. Then tomorrow, it's forecast to warm up to 18 or 19, 17 at Coldstream, and the Dandenong Ranges will also be cooler, 13. It'll be mostly cloudy during the day before showers develop around midnight. Cloudy in Geelong with a top of 19 degrees, and after a low of 13, the city's also heading for 19, with dry skies until midnight. The showers should clear by Thursday morning, so winter will kick off with a low of 12 and a mostly cloudy top of 16. Then some mild winter weather after that. 17 on Friday, 18 on Saturday with morning showers clearing, 18 again on Sunday with breaks of sunshine, 17 Monday and 16 next Tuesday. And for tomorrow, the final day of autumn, the city is only expected to drop to 13 degrees before peaking at 19 under mostly cloudy skies before showers develop at midnight. And after that, Pete, it's hello winter.
I'm afraid so, Melissa. To wrap up autumn, it'll be just as chilly. But some good news then for the first couple of days of winter. We will start with some slightly warmer mornings and much warmer days. We're looking at 26 degrees on Thursday now in the city. We'll get to that in your seven-day outlook. A look at temperatures with our flyover over southeast Queensland. The overnight low in the southeast was minus one in Ipswich and also Conunga in the Gold Coast hinterland. Daytime highs, low 20s on the coast and bayside, while the max today, 23 degrees, shared between Brisbane, Archerfield, Ipswich, Greenbank, Caboolture, Beaudesert and Gatton. The weather map, a low and a trough across the southwest of WA, bringing showers, gusty winds and a few storms. A front crossing Tassie and southern Victoria will trigger showers and gusty winds. Interstate, showers in Perth, Melbourne and Hobart, cloudy in Canberra, sunny in Alice Springs and 25, Darwin 30. Queensland, late showers for Cairns, partly cloudy, Townsville and Mackay. Beautiful sunny day with mid-20s across the Capricornia, Wide Bay and Burnett. Sunny and warm inland for Mount Isa and Longreach. A cold morning in Roma, but a mild sunny day. Here in the southeast, early frost in the southern interior. A fine sunny day will follow with light winds. Overnight temperatures, sort of single digits, but low single digits tomorrow. Daytime temperatures, we're looking at mid-20s. Moreton Bay, west-northwesterly, 5 to 10 knots. It'll be beautiful on the bay with a north-northeaster early afternoon. Brizzy, sunny day, light winds. The overnight low, 9 degrees, a top of 24. But your seven-day outlook, well, a magic start to winter. Sunny and around 25, close to 26 degrees. Another 25 to go day Friday. Becoming cloudy for the weekend with a few showers. Heavier falls Monday. Ipswich, sunny and warm start to June. 26 for Thursday and Friday, a late shower Saturday, a few showers Sunday, increasing for Monday. For the Goldie, sunny and light winds Thursday and Friday with 24 each day, showers developing Saturday and increasing later Sunday for a wet Monday. Sunshine Coast, early fog Thursday, sunny warm winter's day, Friday mostly sunny and 24. Cloud will increase over the weekend with a few showers, but the heaviest falls will be back to work Monday. Melissa.
Yeah, thanks, Kate. I think I can hear the Living End doing their sound check over at Adelaide Oval at the moment ahead of the State of Origin tomorrow night. I forgot how good they were. It sounds like they're going to be fantastic if you are heading in. And the good news is it looks like the weather should play ball as well. Today we did see cooler conditions, a few showers around, particularly through the morning, on and off throughout the afternoon. 17 and a half was our top. Now, across the suburbs, it was kind of a little bit before 9 o'clock we saw those showers starting to come through. Nothing too heavy, a millimetre or so here and there. I think we got around 3 millimetres in the city, and it was just under 18 degrees at Glenelg. Mostly dry and into the 20s through the north today, with 23 at Cooper Pedy and Port Augusta. And the sprinkles continued at Victor Harbour with around a millimetre there. Some more light splashes on Kangaroo Island too. On the charts, there's a front coming in tomorrow, but it's more so just clipping the bottom of South Australia as well as southern Victoria and Tasmania. So if you're travelling tomorrow, Melbourne could see a shower or two, and Hobart is looking wet and in fact really windy, potentially some strong gusty conditions there. We are allowing ourselves to climb up into the mid-20s through our north tomorrow. Roxby Downs and Port Augusta 25 and Whyalla 23. Looking mostly dry from Port Lincoln across to Victor Harbour. There's still the chance of showers further south around Narracourt and Mount Gambier, with the weather just clipping the south of the state there. And as a result, we still do have that marine wind warning in place for the lower southeast coast too. On local waters, though, around Adelaide, north-northwesterlies reaching up to 20 knots south of Brighton during the day, then decreasing to about 10 knots late evening. Tomorrow, for the last day of autumn, can you believe it? The slight chance of a shower about the hills or the southern suburbs, but apart from that, we're looking basically dry, and a nice little temperature rise in store too, with 20 degrees for Glenelg and Noarlunga. In the city as well, we're going for that basically dry top of 20 degrees with an overnight low tonight of around 12 degrees. First day of winter, we might even catch a little bit of sun with a top of 20 degrees, looking mostly dry. On the weekend, look, Saturday is probably the drier of the 2 days. There is the chance of showers creeping back onto the forecast from Sunday, but of course the seasons are well and truly changing now, so we can get used to that.
Thanks, Mon. Well, we've had a spitting of rain today, but we're about to get a good deal more of it overnight tonight as a big cold front rolls through. Now, all the air pushed ahead of that system actually gave us a day on the milder side today. We managed a top of 24 degrees at 2:30 this afternoon, and it is still lovely out here, currently around 19 degrees. But if we take a look ahead now across the country, sunny in Brisbane tomorrow, a top of 24 degrees, partly cloudy and 21 in Sydney. Melbourne, a
couple of showers tomorrow, heading for 19 degrees. To Perth now, and the heaviest falls will arrive before lunchtime, with storms rolling through. Some suburbs could see up to 15 millimetres of rain, and heading for a top of 21 degrees. The first day of winter, some light showers in the morning, but that will clear off quite quickly to a mostly sunny afternoon, a top of 19 degrees, but a bit of a chill. It will feel closer to 13 at the time. Some chilly mornings to follow, getting down to 6 degrees, and for the long weekend, showers returning late Sunday, and for WA Day, we could see up to 30 millimetres of rain, a further 35 millimetres on Tuesday morning. So winter is certainly kicking off with a bang.
It sure is. Thanks, Sherry.